Hey, Barbara here with Cycling Strong. So hey, we are here right now doing a quick video on a product that you may want to check out. We were walking down the aisle and a guy said, hey, what are you videoing? We said, well, mainly for road bikes and mountain bike stuff. He goes, well, check this out. So what it is, it's a light that actually sits and blinks, but it's got an accelerometer in it, I guess, that when you stop. So Fred's going to tell us a little bit about the product and why we all should have it on our bikes. Go ahead, Fred.
Product started when I was following a person, and that individual happened to stop suddenly for a kid crossing in front of him. He stopped. I wasn't aware that he had stopped until I hit him. I hit him. I fell over like this, broke my wrist. On Thanksgiving Day, 3 years ago, I was in the hospital, and I said, it seems to make sense that there should definitely be a product that will also indicate when you're braking. Just like for 30 years, it's been mandatory for cars to have brake lights. So over the last year and a half, worked with an R&D team out of LA. We're out of Marin County in the San Francisco Bay Area. We've worked on this so that it does exactly that. It functions as a taillight, just as a normal taillight would function. So it has a night mode where it's flashing. When you do stop completely, or when you come to a slow down, then it turns into a bright 100 lumen light. In the daytime mode, it's like this. It's off as you're riding. As soon as you slow down 3 to 5 miles an hour or come to a complete stop, the light, once again, goes on 100 lumens. And like you said, it functions with an accelerometer, but what we've done is, in addition to adding some customized and patent-pending circuitry, it uses also a gyroscope. And the gyroscope is simply meant to offset any, I call it false positive. If you're turning, naturally the bike is slowing down. And you don't want the brake light to go on just because you're slowing down. So the gyroscope adjusts for that, recognize that, and the gyroscope makes sure the brake light doesn't go on until, once again, you resume driving. Car comes in front of you, kid comes in front of you, boom, the light goes on, indicating to a cyclist behind you or a car. When I returned to San Francisco just about a year ago, the day I returned, I read an article in San Francisco, three commuters were actually hit by a car behind them. And that sort of consolidated my desire. Yeah. To increase the safety component.
All right, great. So the other big thing, obviously, is we all, I guess my fear is, I ride a Pinarello,
right,
high-end bike, I look at this right here, and I'm worried that's gonna scratch the crap out of my bike. So how does that work on there? And tell me, have you got a rubber thing there? Or what kind is this made out of so that it does not scratch my bike up and make it look bad?
Sure. All right, well, first of all, let's say the top part is your basic, I call it your basic rubber band strap.
Yeah.
That's a reinforced, rubberized material that's designed to last many, many, many times. The bottom part is it's a soft but adjustable plastic that'll take three different kinds of seat posts. If you move it on carefully, it goes on pretty simply like that, you can see. And because it is this rubberized material, it's not good. I've put this on and off of my bike many times, and you can see there's no scratching.
You make a longer strap for it too, or is that the length that it comes?
Adjust the length of the strap, because yeah, this is going to be available in the first quarter next year. So adjust the strap. Plus, we're coming up with a few other modifications that may enable it to go on seat posts when you have a bag underneath here,
right,
but and you have a shorter post. So
yep,
we're looking at making another model that will actually have a rubber band like this, and it'll eliminate that. So it'll shorten this, so it'll give you an extra inch and a half of space there.
Or mount it somewhere like this.
You could mount it like that. As a result of a lot of interest here, we've also looked at this fitting on electric vehicles.
Yeah.
You know, electric is obviously
not our market right now, but that's awesome. But for out there riding your bike and everything like that, guys, safety's everything. You know that. You know, I believe in it. I ride with a light all the time. Mine's mounted down here on the frame. I think it's a great idea. Obviously, the more exposure you can get when you're braking and different things that way and get attention of a driver, the better off you're going to be. So get out there, keep riding your bike, have an awesome day today, and have fun. See you later.